Welcome, everybody. I'm Matt Rao from Videomasters TV, as you know, and I'm here today with the cameraman Kevin Castillo, my friend, and we're here at the Portland Retro Gaming Expo 2008 in Portland, Oregon, USA. Today we're walking around and we're just seeing how the third annual Retro CGE of the Northwest is going, and let's go on in and take a gander.
With modern gaming, my problem with modern gaming and why I don't own any system past the PS2 is it seems like every video game wants to be a movie. Like there's tons of cutscenes and long drawn out storylines and blah blah blah. Just let me play a little Twitch gaming and then I can just set it down and call it good.
We've got a coach here for Classic Gaming, and please introduce yourself, sir.
My name is John Hancock. I'm a Northwest Classic Game Enthusiast staff member, and I'm just one of the people that helped put on the show.
That's awesome. What does it take to get a show like this going here?
A lot of people coming together without egos and just working together to, hey, let's put on a game show. What's it going to take? And that's exactly what you're seeing today. It's just tons of hard work from staff members and volunteers and just people that want to have a game show.
That's really awesome. So you guys are having championships today?
Oh yeah.
We're gonna do an Atari 2600 championship at 5 o'clock, followed by the debut of High Score movie. Yep.
Can you talk a little bit about the movie High Score?
It's a local person. Actually, I'm embarrassed to forget his name, but it's pretty much High Score movie is about a gentleman trying to beat the Missile Command High Score. It's kind of in the same venue as King of Kong.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's going to be here to talk about it, and it's going to be at 7 o'clock. And it's just it's a great movie.
All right. Well, thank you, sir, for talking, and I hope your judging goes well as they play the championship. All right. Thanks, man.
Hi, I'm Fred Quimby. I'm an Atari 2600 enthusiast. I've been playing the Atari 2600 ever since 1980 when I got one for Christmas, and basically never put it away. Mm-hmm. And then Atari Age came around, and I noticed a lot of people running homebrews. And this is the first thing I ever did. It's basically I modified the original Venture cartridge. It originally had 2 levels, but the arcade version had 3. So I went and added the 3rd level. And today I decided to make 20 limited edition cartridges and sell them here at the show. And last year I made this homebrew, Gingerbread Man. I made it in a language I created for the Atari 2600 called Batari Basic. Yeah, and you can download that at BataraBasic.com. It's a basic-like language for creating homebrew Atari 2600 games, and several Atari 2600 games have been produced. And what I'm also working on is this is a new board for the Atari 2600.
Wow, that is extremely small.
Yeah, it's a surface mount microcontroller on the board. And it has 32K of ROM and 8K of RAM, which expands the 2600's RAM capabilities by, I can't remember, at least 64 or something. Originally had 128 bytes. There's a couple other projects I'm working on. I have another homebrew called Superbug I'm working on.
Thank you for showing us your work. And I picked up your Venture game a little bit ago, so maybe I will do a review on it on the show in a few months. Hey folks, I'm here with Chuck from Recycled Gamer, and we're at the Expo, the Retro Gaming Expo again. And I'm going to let I'm going to let Chuck explain a little bit about Recycled Gamer, since I can't talk.
I'll do my best. Well, Recycled Gamer was an idea I came up with try to keep... I noticed when I went out to garage sales and thrift stores and even dumpsters, you see a lot of old video game systems in the garbage. And I know there are a lot of people out there who are interested in using their systems, so I came up with the idea of gathering pieces and parts of systems and kind of stockpiling them so I can build complete systems and put them together. And so I've been selling online ever since and coming to these game shows as well.
Cool. Yeah, you have a nice little booth here.
Thank you.
Lots of systems for sale.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, that's for sure. It's a labor of love.
Yeah.
I'm definitely not getting rich doing it or anything.
Yeah.
But it's really a lot of fun to come to the show and see people nostalgic for games they used to play when they were kids. And a lot of little kids that come and play games, the older games. Mm-hmm. My son is 5, and he has a great time playing with these games, the older games.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, my daughter, she's like 2 years old. As soon as she's able to hold a controller, Nintendo and the old Sega.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite old console that you'd...
Well, that's tough, because I grew up with the Atari 2600, and there's certainly a lot of games with that system that the sounds of which are etched in my brain permanently.
Yeah, such as?
Well, the ones that I remember playing the most were Donkey Kong, the Coleco game, and Combat, of course, is a classic. Tank Pong, I could play that all day.
Mm-hmm.
And even the Pac-Man, as horrible as it was one that we all played a lot. And all the songs, the sounds from that game. You hear them in commercials nowadays, and you're like, that's from Atari 2600 Pac-Man.
Yeah, they're targeting us.
Exactly. And but coming up into the more modern systems, Nintendo 64 is one I really enjoy right now because it was the first real 3D game platform that that I played, and so I really enjoy playing a lot of those games and downloading them on the Wii Virtual Console.
Yeah, cool. All right, Chuck, thanks very much.
Of course.
And we'll see you soon.
All right.
Bye.